Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you had a good lunch and do not feel sleepy with my session. I'll try to make it a little more interesting as much as I can. If I'm a little nervous, please cooperate. Okay, let's go. Hi, my name is Ashish, Jain, and it has no relevancy or relation with the drug called as Ashish. Well, the meaning of this name is blessings. Ashish means blessings. So now you can connect with this name in a more better manner. This is my Twitter handle, and what I do, I Drupal every day at my company, Adam Solution. One liner about me as a person: passion excites me, and ignorance of any kind disappoints me. After all, we are human beings. We have got the brains. We know what is right, what is wrong. So if we can differentiate between them, let's not ignore it. So that disappoints me a lot. Yatra naryastu pujyante ramante tatra devta. Yatra tastu na pujyante sarvastra trafla kriya. What was that? Well, I'm sure nobody has understood what I just chanted. It's an ancient verb in one of the world's oldest language, which is Sanskrit, and I'll tell you the meaning of it pretty soon and why I chanted this as well. So here's the meaning. The divine are extremely happy where women are respected, where they are not, all the actions are fruitless. Now, if anybody can help me to pronounce it in German, because my German is not good. So I got that translation to the perfection, not by using Google Translator, but because of this guy. He's from Berlin, Reinhard. Thank you so much for this translation. If anybody can read out this in German, that would be great. Yeah, and
das göttliche Produkt, wo Frauen respektiert werden, wo nicht, ist alles eitel.
In French and in Italian, if somebody is comfortable with that. Well, why I chanted this? I mean, I haven't yet shown you what I'm going to cover today, but I somehow chanted a verb in the ancient language. Well, it shows the century-old values from the land that I come from. It has been taught to us since our childhood, and we were going to pass it to the generations to come. So that is the value of the land that I come from. So though for those who joined me, this is a Sanskrit verb. It means the divine are extremely happy where women are respected, and where they are not, all the actions are fruitless. Let's take a quick look about a brief journey about the points that we were going to cover in today's session. I'll talk about brief women achievers, and then women in tech and senior positions around the globe. I'll also talk about some human ratio, and then I'll come take our journey towards our experience, the challenge, the solution, and the impact that we had in our small and happy organization in India. And there could be different experiences from your end, so I would be happy to listen to your opinion and experiences as well as the session progresses. And how we celebrate womenhood in our company, and a small thank you note from lovely ladies in Adweb to the entire Drupal community. Okay, so before we begin our session, let's remember the seven women coders who paved the way for women in tech. Ada Lovelace is the oldest known computer programmer so far by Google, and Grace Hopper, she invented compiler that led to the discovery of COBOL. Barbara Leskov, she invented two programming languages, out of which one laid the foundation for OOPS concept. So all of these were born before 1950. Again, imagine the technology was not that good, the awareness was not that good, but still, despite all those odds, they were able to pave the way for women in tech. So thank you, lovely ladies. Now, let's have a quick look about women achievers. Okay, before I go to this, this session is by any means not at all the comparison between the genders. So please do not perceive or have that preset mindset that this is about gender comparison. It's not at all about that. I'm just highlighting what women did in the past and what we are doing because of the disturbing ratio of tech women. So these are the brief women achievers. I mean, the list is countless since human inception. But then due to paucity of time, I'm just highlighting very few of them. And all of them you can see are pretty old ladies. I'm not highlighting the new achievers because they have got the awareness, the opportunity. These were the ladies who never got the opportunity. They created their own path. When the awareness was not there, when the facilities were not there, when the education was not that prevalent, when the civilization was not that developed, but still they made it their way. Kalpana Chawla, first woman of Indian origin in space. Sally Ride, first woman ever to reach in space. Yes, please.
No. First American
to reach in space. Oh, is that so? Sorry. Thank you. First American woman to reach in space. And Mother Teresa, I'm sure everybody knows, a very noble person, very kind. She worked, she came to India and she worked her entire life to serve the poor and the destitute in West Bengal, in the east coast of India. And Junko Tebai, the first woman to climb Mount Everest. I was in Switzerland last month in Davos camp. I was scared to climb a small peak and climbing in Mount Everest, it's wow. Oprah Winfrey faced the racist criticism, still able to succeed in her career. So a lot of examples that we can talk about, the list is endless. The point is that I'm trying to convey is that the struggle they faced, the obsession they had, the zeal to perform they had, made us what they reached in their life today, a few years ago. What's that? Mount Everest. Yeah? So, there's a small kid in May 2014 from the tribal region of India. She climbed Mount Everest at the age of 13 years, 11 months in 52 days. At the age when kids are coloring their textbooks, trying to work out their mathematical problems, she climbed Mount Everest. And last month only, the movie was also got released on her life story, on her achievement. So it's just amazing. Coming from a tribal background, wherein forget about the comfort, not even the basic necessities like water and electricity are there. Education, having education is like an achievement over there. It's not a basic right. From that background and reaching Mount Everest peak, super. Now let's have a look at the proportion of senior management roles held by women across the globe. If you'll see, it's except one region or two regions, it's all of them are less than 30% in the senior management roles. It's the stat of Q4 2015. I have all the source URLs in the presentation as well. Look at the stats of women in tech industry. We all know the name of these companies, that's why I selected these big names. Except Amazon, the ratio is 20 or less than 20. And even in Amazon, it's 30%, 37% because it does not separate tech and non-tech positions. That's why it's 37%. And startups is the new fashion nowadays. So Forbes study, it has been released last week only. It shows that the startups with female founders grow faster. And it's I have a proof with this claim. I can share the link as well. So Did you take a picture? Thank you, Karen.
No.
And now let's have a look at the world human ratio. All the blues, higher females. All the pink, higher males. The green, equal ratio. It's on the broader perspective. I took this picture from Wikipedia. So the human ratio is also good in terms of male to female. So what we observed till now? Well, it's clearly seen that women are widely spread across multiple verticals, whether fashion industry, whether acting, whether aviation, whether politics, whether defense. So they are capable. That's why they reached, they have attained this level in their career, in their life. So that means any capability is not the reason behind this low ratio. And then I thought, could it be because the women are lesser on this planet? Well, they are not. We have seen the human ratio. The ratio is pretty good. So we have beautiful ladies on this planet as well. So there's no scarcity of women as well on the planet. A lot of, just have a quick look at the tweets that trot around the globe. A lot of talks happen about, the challenges that women have faced at the work environment, the achievements that they have made. A lot of initiatives are also being taken by different organizations. A lot of talk shows happen. A lot of appreciation happens. But then, still, the ratio is not that good. So where does the problem lie? Well, I want to briefly talk about our experience in the organization over here. And if you have anything to add to what I have presented so far, feel free to give me your inputs as well. Our experience. I'll again begin this with a small famous saying by a century old monk who traveled to UK.
But then, when you know, you see the cleaner, they are more women, and when you see, the bosses, they are more men. Then, just with this data, in general, maybe you get the idea that we are equal, but when you go deeper into the data, you realize that this equal situation is not so real.
Right. Yeah, that's true. I mean, when we look at the data and what is there in the actual life, it's different. What happened? Okay, cool. Okay, so that was a quick brief about our experience. Now, let's talk about the challenge, the actual, where does the actual problem lie? The ignorance about the very much problem, the ignorance about the very much topic, the ignorance about the very much fact. That's one of the challenges that we need to deal with. Breaking the myth is that although it is not that widespread, but then still it does exist, which is women are not good coders. So that's the myth that we need to break. Or it's like women have their different set of priorities. So that's the myth that we need to break. It's the priority, the career versus family, especially when they get married. So they have to take care of their family or their children, their mother. So then they have to decide between their priority towards, okay, do I need to continue with my work or do I need to take care of my family and I'm okay, I'm done with the work life. And we as an organization faced this challenge somewhere down the line, being tagged as biased in terms of hiring. which was never the case. All we wanted was to increase the diversity, to become inclusive, to create an inclusive work environment. If we see potential in a female candidate, which is not up to the mark, however, if we identify that this particular person is trainable, this particular person can be groomed, possess that basic set of capability, let's take ahead. We'll manage, no problem. So these are the kind of challenges that we faced. So, well, if there are challenges, then there is a solution as well. That's what the life is all about. So, taking care of the first challenge, which was ignorance about the fact, we spread the awareness that Drupal is a great career path. It is not just about coding. As mentioned in yesterday's keynote, that Drupal is not just about coding, you can contribute in many ways. So does, apart from contribution, you are choosing for a great career path, then Drupal does offer a great career path to you. It's just amazing. Many levels. If you don't do coding, or if you don't like that particular perspective, then still you can become a Drupal developer by going for a theming option, or you can be a QA, or you can be a project manager, managing the accounts with a client. There are widespread of activities that you can do in Drupal to choose to have a great career path. We have an example wherein there was a lady. She joined us in Jan 2013 as a trainee, and today she is one of the Drupal leads in our company. So she came a long way. I have a picture of her, I'll share it with you. A long way, she came a long way. It was just amazing journey. She started from zero. And she was new to Drupal, she was not doing theming, she was not doing coding. She opted her own way, okay, I'm feeling more comfortable in doing that. And she carved her own career path. Then the next solution was preserving their interest. It's like if a particular lady is not comfortable with backend, no problem. We have other options available for you. So we have to preserve their interest in terms of career path. So that was the solution that we implemented. That's okay. We don't want to leave a good talented person from our company. Perfectly fine. If you have your interest in front end or interest in QA, you're welcome to join that position. Valuing their priorities. So, talking about the challenge that I mentioned in one of my previous slides, that priority, well, the career or the family, so we need to value their priorities. How we do that? Well, we have set recent examples as well while walking this talk, wherein there were a few ladies who left us in between our journey due to their wedding and all those things, as they wanted a break. And once the marriage was over, once they are back in the town, and they were like, can we join again? They were like, why not? You know the process, you know the working culture, and we would like to have you. But then there were some constraints after marriage, that okay, I cannot work full time. I want to work, but due to certain other commitments, I cannot work full time. So would you be able to become flexible in getting me on board, maybe so I can work 4 hours a day, or maybe 3 days a week, something like that kind of arrangement? Yes, we are open for that. So we valued their priorities to balance the work, the life, and retaining the talented pool in parallel. We created inclusive work environment which is open to diversity. It is not about that, yeah, we just need to work, get the work done, so let's hire the people who are good in coding. It's good to have them, but then we have to create an environment wherein we promote inclusivity. Then okay, even if she's not good enough to code, but if she's capable to be trained and groomed, hire them, promote the inclusivity. Give them a good work environment. Basically, it's respect for all. Last but not the least, competent compensation. It is a very, well-kept, known secret that the compensation is not competent enough, or the compensation is not equal when it comes to male to female. And we knew that it exists in industry. But then, since we wanted to retain good people, we never thought of differentiating between genders in terms of providing any compensation to them. So, providing competent compensation helped us to retain them a lot. And while implementing these solutions, we are actually thankful to their families as well, who supported them a lot to opt career in the technical industry and pave the way to become a strong women in tech. So I mean, it was just amazing. So basically, all of these solutions helped us to retain great talent and have a fantastic work environment at our place. Some quick pictures, as you can see. This is from the gangster day that we celebrated. These two pictures that you have to come to office in a gangster attire in office. So, and then this was a headband day that you have to come to office decorating your head in something. And that was for Drupal 8 release party. This was something traditional day, the birthday party, the team lunch. And then the top one, that is from outing that we had together in the city of Lakes in one of the city in India, out of our office. So it was just amazing. This is White Day. This is a very old photograph. We celebrated White Day. So all of these celebrations, they happened just because, I mean, I personally believe that women are creative. And all of these, I mean, these two ladies, they always take initiative. Like in the recent initiative that they are planning to take is to dance, to start their day with the dancing for 5 minutes. So I was like, yeah, let's do that. So it helps to have a cheerful work environment as well, by the way. So Drupal Con Asia, it's me, my CTO, and that lady, this is a lady who started as a trainee and has become a Drupal lead. Superb journey. And some photographs from Drupal Con Asia last year. It was me, my CTO, and then only two ladies who joined us in the Drupal Con. It was just amazing. Celebrated recently the International Women's Day in our office. Pink day, guys, compulsorily has to give something to the ladies, a chocolate and any gift that you would like to. Any chocolate that you would like to. So that's how we celebrated the womenhood at our company. And it was a good work environment. So the impact, what is the impact? A great cheerful work environment, as you've already seen in some of the photographs. More can be found on our Facebook, company's Facebook page. We keep uploading them. And so a great cheerful work environment leads to a better productivity. Happy me is equal to happy my work. So that's a simple logic. And then families, they realize that women are earning well, and hence that helps them to earn respect in their families, respect in the society as well. That wow, she's having a good compensation, so we should support her. And it's a feeling of content when you support your family. Like in there was a lady whose father was not economically competent, but then somehow he managed to let her study, and now she is earning very high figures compared to her father. So it is a feeling of content, it is a feeling of boost your self-confidence that yeah, we are earning well, we are equally qualified, we are equally capable, we are equally competent. We just give them the platform to perform and they accept. So it's like a valuable change in the society. They are leading from the front, they are becoming role models for the ladies in their locality, in their local area, that yeah, wow, she's performing well in her company. I mean, there's a good career path that I can choose, I can learn from her. So they are becoming role models in their small locality. In last, it's like they are equal driving force in the growing economy that we are having. So that's really a win-win situation. That's an interesting stat that I got. 2015 and 2016. Pink ladies, blue guys. It's the number of Drupal contributions being made from our company. So have a look at this figure. That's phenomenal. In 2016. Wow. It includes forum replies, it includes patches, it includes RTBCs, it includes documentation edits, it includes everything. Any single contribution that we as a company are doing, we are tracking them, and this is the stat. So it's, I mean, the stat says that we are having a, we are having a proven great working environment, and the results are seen. Some good reads. I had a lot of research, there are some good reads. If you guys could find my slides online, you can take some time to read some great business reviews and studies from the well-known institutions across the world about diversity in company and work. Okay, so last but not the least, a brief thank you note from lovely ladies of Adobe Solution in India. And yeah, looks like as he's connected. Yeah, maybe that works.
So just open the tab, I think you just got locked out.
No, it's open, but it still says not connected. Why don't you switch it off? Let me restart it. Okay, not a problem. I have it. No, I've already saved it, so. Yeah, it's really difficult to carry that paper anywhere, anytime. Can this be connected to speaker?
I don't know, to be honest. We never tried.
Let me see if that
Yeah, works. That might work. Yeah. If you switch it on.
Yeah, I'll just switch it off and then. Yeah, that works. I'll see
if you guys can hear this voice. The ratio there is already quite balanced.
Yeah. Towards them.
And my question would be, how is it in India? Is it that you can do that easily because also in India there's a more balance towards women and men in higher education? Or?
Well, it's I agree to your point to an extent, but it is not completely true, because even if you do not have a technical degree under your belt, you can still excel in the tech industry, right? Being a BA or being in politics, degree, anything, you can still come to technical field. Myself, I'm an electrical engineer by qualification, but I'm into software industry. So that does make an impact, yes, but in India, when you talk about particular, coming to your question, after college, like in, we have some training institutes, the skill development programs that are being run by government. So colleges cover a wide range of subjects, but those skill institutes, they cover specific subject. For example, by the time you are out of the college, you realize that coding is not my passion, or I'm very much passionate about QA, or I'm very much passionate about drafting proposals, or I just need to improvise on my English writing skills, so I will opt for that career path. So those training institutes help them a lot. Colleges help them to identify their interests, their skills, try their hands on different subjects that they are offering during the 3 or 4 year of course. And then the skill development training institutes, they last for 2 months to somewhere around 6 months. And then they take internship in the companies like us, and if we find them capable enough, we pull them in.
Would you say female employees are more loyal than male employees, or is that the same?
I knew that this comparison would come. I knew that. Nothing personal against any gender, but the answer is yes.
More loyal.
I would honestly say yes. Yes. I mean, me being one of the founder of this company, having access to all the confidential data, and my right hand in my company is a female employee. I cannot trust anybody else accessing any of the data that I have access to, whether it is related to payments, salaries, whether it is related to client dealings or anything. So yeah, and they are basically, women tend to play safe. They would not like to, you know, do dirty things and just leave their organization on a bad note as compared to male. Like, I've seen people, like we had a bad hire a couple of months ago. When we did the background check, we found that that guy fought with the last company and he just left. So it was like, you would not find such cases happening too much with the female people. Yep.
I don't think that every woman, that you could trust to every woman, maybe it's just this person, and maybe you can trust to some men.
Yeah, I talked about my experience.
And I think that maybe also the woman in this case, that maybe they are more loyal because they think that they have to thank you to give them this opportunity, and the man maybe can think that they have more opportunities.
Right.
And they can change.
That's right. That's right. I'll just show you one thing to add on to this.
Yeah.
So this lady, she joined us in, last year, and approximately after 1.5 months, she got pregnant and she was not able to work. So she was like, I will leave, my career is shattered, I'm upset, and all those things. She was very disappointed that she wanted to pursue her career and then the pregnancy came in between. So I was like, that's okay, it's good, congratulations, take care of your health, we would be happy to welcome you. And she's rejoining on 10th of May.
Yeah, regarding that, I know that we are not in a perfect world, I realize this, okay? But at least in paper, I would like to see that the solution between the family and the career is that we share this current thing. Because if this family, I mean, if this decision is just for the woman, someone has to take care about the old person, about the children. But if this question is just in the woman, we are going to be always in different positions. We need to share this current, and then everyone is going to have this same life decision, if they are going to work more or they are going to live with the family. And maybe if both can make this decision, they are in the same level of the career. Because if you stop to work for 4 years, then your career change. It's not the same, like, still be in the company, and then you are going to grow up in the company.
No, I think that it is our responsibility as business owners to provide a healthy environment that makes it equal. This is what we have been trying to do, and I think like what you are also trying to do is to say like we are trying to create an environment where it is possible for both women and men to be treated equal. Yeah. And that's a problem in Germany, and it's a big problem in Germany. I can say that as coming from Scandinavia, where something like how it is in Germany, this doesn't exist in Scandinavia. In Scandinavia, the working hours are shorter in order to be able to provide, so both can take care of the family. Here it's different, here when the man goes to work everybody goes to work at 9, right?
Yep.
Women come home at 2 because they have to take care of everything else. And
yep.
Because women come home at 2, the man can first come home at 8. And this is our responsibility. And there are a lot of things that can be also done. So for example, in Germany, and for those who are running companies, there's all this with netto salaries optimization. So for example, we as a company, we can pay kindergarten.
Mm-hmm.
We can help out. So you get more out of netto. You know, there's all kinds of stuff where you can say like, okay, I have families, and this is our responsibility, like of around here and you and those who are running companies, that we try to make this normal.
Yeah, I mean,
you get out there and just say exactly what you're saying.
Right. I mean, adding to your point of timing, like one more point to your timing. Like in, she wanted to come early in the office. So I was like, yeah, you can start your day at 7 if you would like to. She was like, wow, that is what I wanted. Because I have to take care of my small kid.
Yeah.
So I said, yeah, it's okay, you can take care of the Australian market because 7 o'clock in India is easily good overlap with the Australian market. And I was like, wow, she solves my problem of getting into Australian market.
Yeah. What I meant was regarding your life about the solution. The solution was that the woman can make flexible hours. And the solution for me, at least in paper, should be that we share these needs for the family. At least in paper, then we can keep working. But
yeah, I mean, it's a challenge that I mentioned, priority. I mean, whether it is family or the career.
But not for the woman, for everyone. This should be for everyone.
Balanced.
Yeah,
it should be.
Should be, yeah, but at this in paper, I would like to see transmit this idea. And because it's the reality, this is the solution. The other part is like what we can do now with this world currently, but the future should be this equality.
Yeah, it has to be there. But that's why I'm here to share our experience. I mentioned that this is a small, humble beginning. We have a long way to go. We have evolved with time, we have learned a lot with time, we have faced the challenges. For example, if a male guy has to take some leave for his wedding, it would be a week or two. But if a female has to take leave for her wedding, it would be 2 months. So we know that challenge. So, I mean, we are ready for that. But then we are able to retain some good people. That is what matters. Good people, good work, good business, good, I mean, happy clients.
Yeah, but
it's worth.
To take care about your family should be for both.
Both, yeah.
It should be in the future. But at least the solution in paper, again, it should be this one.
Yeah, it's like taking a step in that direction. So this is just one of the steps. And as the awareness spread, as the acceptance spread, I'm sure we could reach that stage as well.
Yeah, and the solution is like the future. That's why I make it my point only.
Yeah.
The solution.
Yeah, yeah, that's right. Absolutely, that is one of the key solutions.
Just as a
We need to stop because the other speaker needs to prepare and stuff.
Sure.
So it would be great if you.
In Iceland, with the maternity leave, for example, in the government, for the equality, you know, this is something that we have like on a bigger level. But a man takes 3 months maternity leave, a woman takes 3 months maternity leave, and then they can choose whether it's a man or the woman who takes the maternity leave.
Right.
So for me, as a person who is trying to hire somebody, I don't even have to think about this, like, oh, maybe the girl is going to go to the interview and I get worried. You know, so it's a solve. And this is like another thing.
So the government is also in